Uranus smells like farts. Yep, that's what we've come to. That's the kind of hard-hitting facts in news today. But on a serious note, this is actually legit and really gross. Yes, this unfortunately named planet actually smells like its name. Who knew? Apparently this planet smells this way due to the gases around it. Yeah, the gases around Uranus is what gives off the smell. How comedically convenient. Scientists were able to determine this smell thanks to the Gemini North Telescope in Hawaii. They discovered clouds of hydrogen sulfide and ammonia. And as you may know, hydrogen sulfide smells like rotten eggs. Now, while this is a funny joke, this discovery could actually also help explain the formation of the solar system. About this, Professor Patrick Irwin from the University of Oxford had this to say. It adds another piece of information about the planets and how they form. Uranus and Neptune formed in a colder part of the solar nebula, in early stages of our solar system, when it was just our young sun and lots of dust, then Jupiter, then Saturn. So this helps us to know that hydrogen sulfide is less easily absorbed by the giant planets including Jupiter, Saturn, and Neptune. As we know, or should know, Uranus is a seventh planet from the Sun, and it was originally thought to have hydrogen sulfide after the Voyager 2 probe flew by the planet in 1986. And now the latest data confirms the stinky gas clouds. I want to know, what is your favorite planet? Let me know your answers down in the comment. Mine used to be Pluto. RIP. Hey guys, welcome back to LP, I'm Court McGinley. I hope you're having a wonderful day so far. We are officially halfway through the week and the weekend is right around the corner, so can't wait for that. And it just so happens that Miss Rhode Island, Cheryl Fraser, would say today, April 25th, is her idea of the perfect date. Alright, as you guys know, we have a lot of interesting news stories headed your way, so without further ado, let's get started. Yesterday I talked to you guys all about the horrible van attack that took place here in Toronto. Well, now it looks like they possibly found a motive for this attack. There was a Facebook post that police suspect was written by Alec, who is the Toronto van attack suspect. In the post, there is a militaristic language, and the post is actually linked to an online group of men who feel victimized due to them being celibate. It's also been reported this post was updated just before the attack on Monday afternoon. The Facebook post appeared on the account for a user with the name Alex Manassian, and it read, "The incel rebellion has already begun. We will overthrow all of the Chads and Stacys. All hail the supreme gentleman, Elliot Roger." For those of you who don't know, Elliot Roger was a 22-year-old mass murderer that killed 6 people and then himself in 2014. Before the massacre, Elliot uploaded a video onto YouTube where he said he carried out the killings because he was still a virgin. After an investigation on Facebook's part, they confirmed that this post did in fact come from Alex's account, and not just someone trying to pose as him. The community has since shut down the account. Now, as I said before, in the post it mentioned the incel rebellion. And back in 1993, incel was actually a group for the involuntarily celibate that was started by a young Canadian woman. It was meant to be a therapeutic place where people could talk to one another about their common beliefs. But now it's been taken over by young men who feel victimized by their celibacy and turned it into a place of anger. Police are still looking into this message and the people involved in the group. As for the victims, a GoFundMe page has been set up for the funeral expenses for the victims' families. So far, nearly $95,000 has been raised since Monday. Next, Trump's travel ban faces the US Supreme Court. The first big showdown between Trump and the Supreme Court is happening. Today is the day when the justices will hear a challenge to the lawfulness of Trump's travel ban targeting people from several Muslim-majority countries. As we all know, back in September, Trump issued a policy that blocks entry into the US from most Muslim countries. The court will consider whether the president can indefinitely keep people out of the country based on nationality. It's also going to look at whether the policy is just aimed at excluding Muslim people from the United States. This travel ban is the first Trump policy to undergo a full-blown Supreme Court review. The justices will be looking at the third version of a policy that Trump first issued a week after taking office. We'll keep you guys up to date on how this hearing went. Next, scientists have discovered a new creature down at the depths of the ocean. Thousands of feet below the ocean's surface, this unidentified squid was recently spotted. It was filmed drifting upside down at a depth of 2,790 feet. In the footage, the squid's body seems to be curled inward very dramatically, tentacles folded in and four limbs extended stiffly outwards. It's pretty cute though, I must say. What's your favorite creature of the sea? Let me know your answers down in the comments. Next, an app has been invented that turns plastic surgery into a game for kids. Yeah, hands up if you think this is a horrible idea. Kids are already suffering with horrible self-esteem at younger and younger in age. What were they thinking this is gonna do? In this game, kids can simulate procedures such as liposuction, nose job, lip fillers, and double eyelid surgery. Yeah, I don't even know what double eyelid surgery is, but I do know that this is a horrible idea. They're basically trying to tell kids plastic surgery can be fun. Never mind that it sends a horrible message about body image in young and impressionable kids, but Let's also forget about the pain, infections, and possible death that can come along with it. Parents are expressing their outrage with this app, and they're trying to get it taken down. Yeah, I should hope so. All right, there you guys have it. That's all the news stories I have for you today. Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to show some love by giving this video a big thumbs up, and I'll catch all of you in the next one.